Hi, I'm Dominic. Thanks for watching Dominic's Woodworks. And today I'm making a pumpkin. Well, it's a wooden pumpkin, of course. And the idea behind it is it has been a pretty warm October around here, and the pumpkins that my girls carved succumbed to mold within 1 or 2 weeks. So I decided to make a wooden pumpkin. They can't carve it, or maybe they could, but actually in this case I did. Anyway, the idea was it wouldn't rot and it could be used as decoration again next year and the year after. And on top of that, I can use some of the floorboards I still have lying around. Average Joe did a similar project for the scrapbin challenge recently, and I put a link up. But I want to make mine a little different, and since I'm using floorboards, I don't need to paint it, don't need any finish. So I started by setting my table saw fence to the dimension I want the cube to be, and started cutting boards to these dimensions, first making longer stripes and then cutting them up into squares. The thing is, with these boards I used my circular saw to cut them up while they were still in the room, and so the edges weren't pretty flush, which means I had to true up one edge on the table saw first, which means that I had to do some additional cuts. Then in the end I have 6 squares, but I want to take advantage of the finish of these boards and don't want the edges to show. So what I'm doing is I'm going to miter them. With the blade set to 45 degrees, I'm making a test cut in a piece of scrap to make sure that the edge comes out crisp and that it doesn't take too much away from the edge. This is important because I'm using the fence, so if I run one side along the blade and it takes away too much from the edge, and I flip it around and run it against the fence with that side, the other side will not be as crisp and the whole thing will not be as pretty or square as it was. Once the whole thing is set up correctly, it's just a matter of running each square through 4 times. 6 times, 4 times. To glue up the cube, I'm using painter's tape as a clamp replacement. I put 2 pieces next to each other and 2 pieces of tape to attach them. And I do that for the first 5 pieces, as you can see, and test fit them before I apply glue. And once I have spread it and put the thing in place, I use another piece of tape to hold it there. I should mention that I'm only gluing up 4 of the 5 pieces that I taped, so keep in mind to leave one without glue for now to do some further work on it. In the meantime, I mark the center of what is supposed to be the lid and use another one of the wooden curtain rod holders that I already used for my scrapbin challenge project to make the stem. And I'm gluing it in place using CA glue. Then I mark 6 holes around that to be air holes, and I take them over to the drill press to cut them out using a Fastener bit. Then I remove the face part from the glue up, the one that I didn't glue in place but used for alignment purposes. After trying to make some marks on it, I just decided to go wild on the drill press. And here's where the actual carving takes place. I'm using a Fastener bit, I think it's a 20mm one, for the eyes. And then I make a few holes for the mouth. Then I work my way down over 50mm. To give these holes a little more of a carved or odd-looking shape. Drilling holes next to each other is pretty simple with the Fastener bit. You just have to make sure that the center pin, the center spur, doesn't hit inside the previous hole. As long as it hits wood, you should be fine. Still be careful when doing something like this. After drilling 2 holes for the nose, I realized that the whole thing looked a little plain, So I started some more in-depth carving by using the Forstner bit to hook out the material on the floorboards to reveal the baseboard underneath to give it a well, actually carved look with a little more depth to it. I did that for the nose, then I added eyebrows and also fangs. While the row of holes looks like teeth for the mouth, the eyes pretty much look like Mickey Mouse, so I used a rasp to even those out a little more and also to take off the worst of the tear out that I got. After I was satisfied with the result, I put the face back in place using the tape that was already there, added glue and used the tape that I had used as clamp before to hold the face in place while the glue sets. After removing all the tape, once the thing has dried, I'm using a block plane to take off the edge on all the edges, since well, both the miter that didn't align properly and the one that did is not that easy to handle, or not that comfortable to handle, and I have been told that I recently disappointed some of my fans because I mentioned a block plane and didn't use it. So here we go. So here we are. Probably can't see a thing. So let me show you. Your very own non-perishable pumpkin. Sitting right next to the Death of Rats. So if you let me do the honors. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. Follow me on the social medias you frequent. Leave a comment down below. And remember to be inspired.